Well, identity theft is the fastest growing crime in the United States, and the cost of this crime is approaching $54 billion a year. Personal finance specialist Skip Cowan has tips to prevent our identity from being stolen, as well as our credit reputation. Good morning, Skip.
Good morning, Nikki. How are you?
I'm great. I'm looking forward to some really important information, as always, from you. You know, as many precautions as we take, is it really possible for us to protect ourselves from identity theft?
Well, I think that's a great question. If somebody is really intent on stealing your identity, chances are they're going to do it.
Oh, goodness. But
if you can purchase identity theft protection services. LifeLock comes to mind. You hear that advertised
sure.
a lot. And what they do is monitor your credit account. So if it has happened, at least you'll know it.
At least you'll know it, yeah. Well, you know, one of the things you say is that shredding is actually the best firewall against identity theft. So what should we be shredding?
Well, first of all, you got to become friends with your threader, your shredder. And that shredder, you don't have to spend a lot of money on it. You can buy one for $35.
Oh, okay. Yeah, on eBay, I think you can even get them even cheaper than that.
Oh, yeah. I mean, that, and first of all, the first thing you ought to shred, and think about this, is your old tax returns.
But how long are we supposed to save them
3 years.
Just three?
Just
not three. Seven?
No. Only three. Now, unless you've defrauded the government. If you've defrauded the government, then you'll find that there is no limit.
Right.
So if you've committed fraud, hang on to those.
Hopefully,
and whatever
most of us
you
have
do, whatever you do, do not throw those tax returns in the trash.
Okay.
I mean, think about it. Your Social Security number's there, your address.
Right.
Your vital information, everything an ID thief needs, bingo, gotcha.
You know what, and you don't even think about that. You really don't.
No.
I think people just put it in a trash bag and toss it.
Oh,
so, okay, so we have, I'm really glad you said that. So 3 years, we only need to save for
three years.
Then shred those tax returns. What else should we shred?
Well, the next thing on my list is bank statements. Now, I gotta wonder how many people still get paper bank statements. I don't.
I do. They still send them to me, even though I'm online.
All right. Shred them.
Really? Okay.
Yeah. Once you've balanced your checkbook and you've looked at all the data, why in the world are you keeping those?
Good point.
Again, you know, you've got your account number, it's got vital information. Get rid of them.
Well, what about things like credit card offers or, you know, if we're getting something for
a credit card? I am sick of credit card offers.
So am I.
Now, there is some place you can go called optout.com, just as an aside, those things will stop.
Okay.
Although
optout.com.
Optout.com. But I've tried that. And they stop for about 6 months, and then they pick up again. I must get three a week.
Yeah, me too.
And, you know, I get so frustrated. All I want to do is just pop in the trash.
I know.
Don't do it.
Really?
Don't do it.
So what do we do? Just shred them?
Shred them. Every time, shred them. Open them up, shred them. Now, you can throw away the stuff that are the rules and the regulations of that particular card.
Right.
But anything with your name and address on it, shred it. Because
guess what?
If I'm an ID thief and I get my hands on that, all I really have to do is change the mailing address.
And accept the offer.
Accept the offer, and suddenly I have a card in your name, and the next thing you know, you're in debt up to your eyeballs.
I didn't even think of that. Okay, well, what about something like convenience checks?
That's an oxymoron, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Think about that. Convenience checks? It's not convenient for me to get these checks. I'm sick of them. Right?
So
I mean, honestly, you open up the offer, and there's a check in there in your name, and it says, gee, you can get an instant loan.
Right.
Well, guess how much the ID thieves love that deal?
They must love it.
Oh, they do, because people get frustrated, and they just toss them, right?
Yep.
That's the dumbest thing you can do.
Such a good point.
The moment you get those darn things, shred them.
Okay, well, now here's another one. I've lived in New Jersey, New York, Pennsylvania, L.A., Miami, all these places. I have all of these old driver's licenses, and I save whatever ones they didn't take away from me.
Why?
Is that a bad thing?
Why are you saving those?
memorabilia of the places I've lived.
What else do you save?
Everything. Is that bad?
Well, yeah.
Number one,
you don't have room to save everything.
True.
But think about this. Again, vital data on something you're not even using.
Yeah.
You know, a driver's license. How about an old passport? You got one of those?
I do.
Do you?
Yeah.
What are you going to do with that?
I guess nothing.
Yeah. Or old credit cards,
right? Don't save any of them, huh?
Nothing.
Oh, my gosh.
Nothing.
Okay. What about things like pay stubs or canceled checks?
Well, that's interesting as well. You know,
okay.
I was at Walmart the other day, and I gave them a check, and they handed it back to me, and I thought, why are you doing that? And then I realized it's that check 21 thing.
Oh, right.
They run it immediately, so I get the check back.
Yes.
And I
yes.
put it in my pocket, and I get home, and the first thing I did was shred it. Because think about this. The only thing
You're
a canceled
right.
check is good for is an ID thief.
So true.
That's it.
And who really thinks that? I mean, okay, let me ask you this now. Let's say somebody's too lazy, doesn't want to go out and buy a shredder. What if we just rip them up really, really well?
Well, if you want to take the time to do that, but make sure you do it crosswise so they can't put it back together. Or perhaps, you know, put half of what you've torn up in one sack and half in another.
Oh, that's a good one.
Now, you can always burn stuff, too.
That's true, too.
You know, but make sure you've got a fire pit or something. You're not burning it in open air because that's a violation as well.
Exactly.
And then you'll get something else you can save called a citation.
What about tickets, old tickets?
Oh, why would you keep those?
That's a good point. Probably not a good point.
Anything that has your ID on it, your social security number, your address, your birth date, get rid of it.
I'm so glad you're saying this because honestly, I mean, I'm making a fool of myself admitting what a pack rat I really am. I love to save things for the purpose of memorabilia when it's good. And obviously, it doesn't make any sense. Literally, dollars and cents it might cost me, but it doesn't make sense.
Well, my wife told me once on an old passport, and she's still got an old passport, so she won't shred hers. I said, why are you keeping this? She said, because I want to look at a picture of me when I was 10 years younger.
Don't we all?
Find something else.
We've got the internet for that now. Yeah. Great information. Skip, thank you. I love when you're here. You enlighten us so much, and
always
I appreciate
a pleasure,
it. I'm buying a shredder this week, by the way.
You should.
And coming up next on New Mexico Style, a no-hassle, one-day remodel that will add value to your home. Value, good thing.